Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for November the 21st of 2019, well, it is titled Simeis 147 Supernova Remnant. So what do we see here? Well, this is what is left over after a star explodes. And in this case, this occurred about 40,000 years ago, or at least the light from it would have reached the Earth about 40,000 years ago, meaning that at that time there would have been a bright new star in the sky. And a supernova can actually outshine pretty much everything else in the sky and can actually be visible during the daylight. Now, most objects we don't see during the day. Sometimes you can see the moon or maybe Venus, but other stars shining brightly are overwhelmed by the brightness of the sun and how bright it makes the sky. A supernova could be easily visible when it occurs this close, and this one, only about 3,000 light years away, is relatively nearby for a supernova. Now, what happens in this type of supernova, which is classified as a type 2, is a massive star has reached the end of its life. And a star like our sun gets its energy from nuclear fusion, fusing lighter elements into heavier elements. And it is fusing hydrogen into helium. And as time goes on, over billions of years, they will go on to fuse heavier and heavier elements. Now, our sun is not massive enough to become a supernova, but a very massive star can fuse elements up to iron, which is the limit to where you can get any energy out of fusion. So once a star forms an iron core, it becomes unstable because there is no way to get energy out of that core any longer. And the core will collapse down, essentially imploding, and then rebound back outward, shoving all of that outer material out into space. Now, those are the outer layers of the star. The core itself compacts down to something extremely dense. Essentially, what happens is that all of the electrons get crushed into the nuclei of the atoms, and we get one gigantic atomic nucleus type object that we call a neutron star, essentially a big ball of neutrons in space. Now, as it collapses, that spins faster and faster, and those neutron stars can often be observed as pulsars. And that just means they're beaming out radiation. And if we happen to be in the path of one of those beams, we will then see a burst of energy from it. And they're spinning very rapidly because of the collapse, meaning that we can get those bursts sometimes several times a second. And that's how fast these small compact neutron stars are spinning. So if you can imagine something the size of a city spinning several times a second, sometimes up to 30, 40, 50 times a second, that is what is really going on with these objects. And that's what's left at the center here. And then the outer layers continue to expand out into space to enrich the interstellar medium to form new generations of stars with the heavy elements that were formed during the star's life and during the supernova explosion. So all elements heavier than hydrogen or helium come from this process. This is where a lot of those heavy elements come from, including a lot of the elements in our body were actually at some point in the distant past a part of a supernova explosion like this. So that was our picture of the day for November the 21st of 2019. It was titled Simeis 147 Supernova Remnant. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.